there was a poll done, and the results found that 57% of the people believe that this next recession will be as bad or worse as the 2008 Great Recession. I found that very surprising, especially because of all the changes that have taken place in the market to make this a different market than what was going on in 2008. So today, let's go over these five key reasons why the 2008 recession will not happen again.
Hi, this is David Pisana, owner of Rise Utah Realty in Orem. I want to share with you why I love Utah County. Join me as we explore the restaurants, businesses, community events, and incredible geography here. This is Utah County Life.
I think the number one and biggest reason which makes this economy different than the last economy is those who are getting a loan have to go full documentation. Full documentation means that you have to prove your income with bank statements, with pay stubs, and with tax returns. And you have to also generally show your assets, how much money you have in the bank. And they will call your employer making sure you actually work there. Back in the day, back in the before the previous crash, they had something called stated income, stated assets, no verification loans. So you pretty much could say, you know, what do you do for a living? I'm a personal trainer. How much do you make? I make $100,000. How much money do you have in the bank? I have $50,000. And then you could get a loan for that. And it was crazy. And so they were proving people that were clearly overstating their income, but, you know, they took it, and that made everybody buy houses that they truly couldn't afford. So the main difference comes down to, by verifying your income, going full documentation, you are actually legitimately qualifying for a house. And that makes the base of people who own homes very stable, and so less likely to go down if anything were to happen in the economy. The second big change goes down to credit scores. A credit score, or sometimes called a FICO, is what banks look at in order to give you loans. And in the previous time, they allowed you to have lower credit scores, and below a certain point, generally below a 620 FICO score, they would call that subprime. And so subprime loans were huge. You had a 580 credit score, and, you know, typically lower credit scores indicate that someone in crisis will probably not pay you back. And so if they already have a low credit score to begin with, they're already in some sort of crisis mode, and yet you're all of a sudden giving them hundreds of thousands of dollars in a mortgage on a stated income loan. You add those two factors together, if they ever lose the desire or motivation to pay you, they're not, okay? And that's what happened. As soon as the market started to go down, they were already leveraged. They typically had other obligations, and they weren't able to pay it really quickly. That's why everything dropped so fast. It just affected it that quickly. So today, we're qualifying on generally good credit. I think the average credit score is over 700 points, which is considered a credit. So that puts us in a much better credit position in terms of the loans that are given out. All right, the third big difference that's happening is there's a lot more regulation today. So there's a lot more government oversight that are looking at these things so that it would stop them from happening again. And what was happening before is that banks were taking these subprime mortgages, and then they would be selling them to the stock market, to insurance companies, as AAA rated great investments. They'd be rated as the nice, secure 30-year investment that people would have on a mutual fund. And what happened, as soon as the market started to turn, everybody realized that they weren't sold. It was like, instead of gold, they realize it's fool's gold, and everything just crumbled from there. And that's where large companies like AIG, which was the largest insurance company at the time, had gone under, because they invested in all these bad loans. So we don't see this relationship between loans and the stock market happening again, because in the last recession, you've got to remember that the mortgages and the fraudulent lending caused the stock market to crash. So they were the cause of it. And this time, they will not be the cause of any stock market crash, because those AAA rated loans are truly good rates, and they won't have the volatility of in previous years. Now, the fourth factor that's really different in this market is the people. A lot of people just lived through this last great recession, and I think there's a lot of PTSD, a lot of post-traumatic stress syndrome from it. And And what one of the results from that is that with the expansion that we've seen over the last 7 years of growth, is that we have more equity in houses now than we have ever had in the history of recording home ownership. And this is great news. Now, the more equity that you have, the less likely you're going to foreclose. Why? Because if you're in financial trouble, you can simply sell your house and sell it for a profit. Take that profit, pay off debt, go to a rental, and you can do that before it hits your credit. So having equity in homes also shows that people are less likely to abandon a house because they don't want to lose the equity. So this factor of the U.S. market having more equity now than in any previous time is huge. And the number that I saw recently was 24.7% as the average percent of equity that people have in their homes today. All right, so the final thing is just looking at the bigger picture is we're on a much more solid foundation. And the foundation is in the state of Utah, we have solid growth. We have a diversified portfolio of growth. It's just not tech. There's healthcare, there's banks. Everybody's coming to our area for growth. It's a great place to live. We have tourism. We are a surplus state, and the overall demand and the influx of people coming into our state is going to create the demand for housing, create the need to continue to build. And it's one of the number one, it probably is the number one reason which will overcome any slowdown that may happen. So if we do see a slowdown, it's anticipated they'll be much shorter, less impactful, and then we'll cruise on into the next decade of growth. All right, I don't want you guys living in fear. That's why I've talked about these five key differences today. Please research them so that you could feel secure in what I'm telling you is true, that our economy is fundamentally different than it was a decade ago. And for those reasons, we're not going to see the dramatic drops in home prices like we did, if any. So research those. We want you to feel comfortable, because in this kind of market, honestly, you should start to get excited for the next decade of growth that we're going to experience. And I honestly believe that those people who invest over this next 10, 20 years are going to make a gob of money, because the value of our real estate is going to skyrocket. Hey, it's David here. Thank you again for watching this video. I really appreciate you supporting the content and your involvement. Please share it with your family and friends so we can keep giving you good stuff. And of course, as always, we are real estate brokers here in the state of Utah. We would love to help you. And we have a huge network outside if you need help there too to find you the best realtor. But give us a call or direct message us below. Thanks.